working as an assistant professor in WIT Solapur. In this video lecture, we are going to learn about the development of the lateral surface of a pentagonal prism. At the end of this video session, students will be able to draw the lateral surface of various regular prisms like square prism, pentagonal, hexagonal prisms. So this is a question. So it is a pentagonal prism with edges of the base 25 mm and axis 65 mm, rests on one of its base edges with an edge of the base parallel to and nearer to the VP. It is cut by a suction plane perpendicular to the VP, which is inclined at 30 degrees to the HP and which is passing through the top end of the axis. A cylindrical plane of radius 30 mm and perpendicular to the VP cuts the prism, and the origin of that passes through the right bottom corner of the prism. Draw the development of the lateral surface of the prism. So for proceeding the answer, so first of all we need to draw the XY line, name it as XY line. Next we need to draw the pentagonal surface with one of its bases parallel to VP. If it is parallel to VP, so one of the edge of the pentagonal surface will be parallel to XY. So I have drawn one edge parallel to VP or XY. So the second line of the pentagonal surface, so it is having an external angle between two lines is 72 degree. And the third line, fourth line and fifth line. So this is a regular pentagonal surface which is having external angle 72 degree each. And after that, so name this with a A, B, C, D, E. So this is representing a bottom pentagonal surface. So because here the pentagonal prism is having two regular pentagonal surfaces arranged, so which are parallel to each other and they are apart a distance of that is equal to the axis height, or that we can call it as a height of the prism. So in the top view we see that two pentagonal surfaces are coinciding with each other. So the bottom surface is naming with the ABCDE and the top surface is with the PQRST. Next, from this we need to draw the projection to draw the front view. So these all are the projections we need to draw the front view. And now this line is indicating the vertical edge of the pentagonal prism, that the name is 80 and it is having 65 mm, the length of axis also. Next, in the line CR we have drawn. Next we need to draw the top surface, that is a PQRST surface. Next, connect the DS vertical edge. Next, these two will be drawn with a dotted line because AP line and BQ vertical edge we cannot see from the front view. So we need to draw this with a dotted line application. Next, name this bottom surface and the top surface with their namings like ABCDE bottom surface and PQRST top surface. Next thing is that, so after this the prism is full prism here. So for the full prism, the development is we get as a rectangular surface of a stretch out line equal to 5 times the edges of the pentagonal surface, that is 25 into 5. We need to draw 125 mm line. Next, 65 mm height line, that is indicating the height of the prism, and the bottom surface and the top surface again with a 125 mm, and connect the corners. So this becomes a development of the full prism. Next, name these with a ABCDE. Here I have divided the 125 mm stretch out line by 5 times because we have 5 corners in the pentagonal surface. So we need to divide this 125 mm line by 5 times and name those with a ABCDE bottom surface. Next, connect this intermediate points from bottom surface to the top surface with the vertical edges and name those as PQRST. Next thing is that, so we need to cut a prism by using two sectional planes or cutting planes. So here one plane is 30 degree with HP and this is passing at what we can say top corner of the axis, and which is 30 degree with HP. And one more cutting plane is a curved plane, which is the center of that is passing through the right bottom corner, so which is having a 30 millimeter radius. So this looks like this after using two section planes. Next thing is that we need to draw the projections from those intersection point between the section planes and the point of intersection with the bottom edge or the bottom surface. So these are the intermediate projections I'm going to draw to get the intermediate points. So now here I have written the point number A on line ED or DE. So next is B, C, D, E, F, G and H. So these are the intermediate points I have drawn or I have written to draw the intermediate points in the development plane also. So next thing is that we need to name the intersection point between the vertical edges and the sectional plane, that is curved section plane. So the first point is coming on line ED. Next thing is that point number 2 is coming on line B. The point 3 is on DS. Point number 4, point number 5, point number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So these are the intermediate points we need to mark to transfer these points on the development plane. We need to clearly observe that so where the points will be coming and why there are two points I have marked and why here only one mark. So since here we have only one vertical edge, so the sectional plane is intersecting it only once, so we need to mark it as one, only one point. So here 5 and 7 is because of here D vertical edge and H vertical edge, so it is intersecting twice, so we need to mark with the two points. So similarly here also C and one more is that BQ vertical edge, so it is intersecting two vertical edges, so I need to mark with two points. So similarly here up to this. Next thing is that we need to mark these points also on ETH, that is 12th point. 13th point is on DS. 14th point again it is on G vertical edge, and 15th point is on AP vertical edge. The next thing is that we need to transfer these intermediate points on the edges of the pentagonal surface. So we need to transfer those points here between these respective edges. So that we can done by transferring the distance from any reference point. So like how we can transfer. So after that we need to transfer or we need to connect the these points from bottom surface to the top surface. So these are called as a vertical edges from those respective points. So next thing is that we need to draw the parallel projections to get the points in the development plane. So that we can done by drawing the parallel projection. So here I have drawn the parallel projection from 2 and 10 point. If you see that the point number 2 is coming on the vertical edge B, and point number 10 is coming on vertical edge F. So this point, this projection is up to this vertical edge B. So we cannot transfer this up to A, because so this projection is only up to this BA. And in the next stage, I'm draw the parallel projection from 3 and 9 point. So since the point number 3 is on a vertical edge, that is a DS, if you see this, so we need to transfer this line up to this DS vertical edge in the development plane. And the point number 9 is coming on this vertical edge, that is 9. So the next is that we need to draw the projection from 4 and 8. So that is coming on C vertical edge, and the point number 8 is coming on vertical edge BQ. So like how we need to transfer all the point projections from all the respective point of intersections. So here we get the point of intersection between these vertical edges and the projections drawn from this respective points. So next thing is that we need to write the names, that is with the 1 to L1. These are the point of intersections on this vertical edge. So write those with 1, 2 here, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to L1. So next thing is that we need to connect these point of intersection with a profile that is smooth profile, that is curve profile, right? So since we need to draw this with a curve profile, because if you see that the curve profile is intersecting the parallel this plane profile, so we get a curve profile as the profile here. So that connect this with a curve line, so this 1 to 12 and 6 to L1. This is the profile after cutting with the curve profile. Next thing is that we need to transfer this point number 12, point number 13, 14 and 15. So point number 12 is up to this ET, because the point number 12 is coming on ET vertical edge. Next is that 15 is coming on PA, since this point is on PA vertical edge. So next, name those point of intersection with the naming 12, 13, 14 and here 15. So we need to connect this 14 and 15 with a straight line, because if you see that this section pin is also a plane surface and it is intersecting a plane surface, so we get a straight edge as a profile. So this is also point number 15 here, because since we have one more PA line here. So connect this 12 and 15 with a straight line, and 12 and 13 straight line, and 13 and 14 with a straight line. If you see that, so this profile is the development of the truncated prism. And after this, we need to increase the thickness of the line, so to indicate that as a development surface of the prism. So like how we need to dark the external lines after cutting. So this plane is the final front view after section or cutting, and this dark surface indicating the development of the prism after cutting. So you can think that, so this is a profile I get if this section plane is 30 degree with the HP. What is the change we can get in the profile if the section plane is 45 degree instead of 30 degree, or this point is passing through this point R? Whether the profile is same or we get some modification in the development plane. This is a reference I used. Thank you.